Today we're going to create a bright neon sign effect using the powers of Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop. While it's possible to construct the entire artwork in Photoshop alone, Illustrator offers some useful tools for producing the initial layout with its vector shape building capabilities. Where Photoshop really shines is with its various layer style options that can be configured to create vibrant lighting effects, which are perfect for depicting a realistic illuminated neon sign. Real neon signs are made out of glass tubes that are bent into shape, so to help with the realism of our neon sign artwork, the linework will be created in a way so there's a start and end point for each segment with no overlaps. Photographs of real neon signs show intense brightness from the tube that appears almost white, but with an ambient glow of a vibrant colour. This will be replicated using Photoshop's inner glow, outer glow and drop shadow effects. So open up Adobe Illustrator to begin and create a new document. I'm using pixel units and the RGB color mode, but the document size doesn't really matter too much. Select the spiral tool from under the line tool menu group and clear out the default white fill. While dragging out the spiral shape, use the cursor keys to reduce the number of curls so the spiral is almost just a complete circle. Hold the command key and drag the shape so the start and end points are fairly close together. Switch to the move tool and squash the shape vertically and reposition it to represent the top of the cocktail glass. In the stroke panel, increase the weight to around 6 points and check the round cap option. Select the pen tool and click on the open end of the spiral to continue its path. Dragging out a bezier handle before releasing the mouse helps continue the path with a smooth curve. Draw the rest of the cocktail glass profile by clicking and dragging points and bezier handles. Stop at the halfway point at the bottom of the glass shape. Ensuring smart guides are enabled will help you snap to the center line. Use the direct selection tool to draw a selection over those new points, then hit Command and C to copy and Command and F to paste in front. Go to Object Transform and Reflect to flip this path and position it on the other side. Make any adjustments to the overall shape of the glass by altering the position of the points if necessary. Because one of the key features of this neon effect is to mimic how the tubes would be formed in a real neon sign, the path needs to have a clear start and end point with no overlap. Use the scissors tool to snip and delete the path in the upper right area. Continue constructing the cocktail glass sign with some additional elements, such as a simple circle to represent a slice of fruit. The scissors tool is needed again to prevent any overlapping paths. Snip both the glass path and the fruit path before and after the intersection, leaving a little space, and delete the unwanted portions. Click a few points to draw a straw shape with straight lines, then go to Effect, Stylize and Round Corners to turn the sharp corner into a bend. Toggle on the preview and select a suitable radius, such as 40 pixels. Next go to Object Path and Offset Path, enter around 7 to 10 pixels to produce parallel lines. Go to Object and Expand Appearance to permanently apply the effect, which will allow you to delete the original path. This straw shape is both a continuous outline and it overlaps the other paths, so more scissors work is required. Snip and delete the ends, then close the top end back up with a straight path using the pen tool. Go to Object Stylize and Round Corners and apply a smaller radius of around 8 pixels or so to just subtly round off the corners of the straw tip. Use the scissors tool to break up the paths where they intersect, leaving a small gap between them. Depending whether you cut the glass or the straw shape, the illustration will have an illusion of depth where one element appears to fit inside the other. To finish off the sign artwork, add a text element with the wording of your choice. Choose a bold font, with italics in my example. Right click and select Convert to Outlines. Switch the default black over to a stroke and set it up with the same 6-point weight, plus round cap and corner options. Zoom into the text and use the scissors tool to process each letter by cutting out a small portion, so each shape is produced by an open-ended path. Adding a round corners effect of just a few pixels also helps eliminate the hard corners to produce a more realistic result. Go to Object Transform and Shear and enter 10 degrees in the Shear Angle option, then scale and position the text within the sign composition. Use the scissors tool again to fix any overlaps so the entire artwork is made of a series of lines that don't cross or touch anywhere. Hold the shift key and use the move tool to click and add all the elements of a particular colour to the selection. Alter the stroke colour to a specific swatch, then press Command and X to cut those elements. Add a new layer and hit Command and F to paste them back in place. Do the same with the next selections of paths in each colour, adding them to their own new layer. Once the design is complete, go to Object Export As, choose PSD, then ensure the Write Layers option is checked. Remember to also save a copy of your Illustrator file so you can make future edits if you ever need to. The second half of this process is conducted in Photoshop using the newly created PSD file. Begin by enlarging the canvas with the crop tool to provide some additional space. You'll see each coloured segment of the artwork is on its own separate layer. Then fill the background with black. Open up a brick wall texture to use as a backdrop for the neon sign artwork. Select all with Command and A, copy with Command and C, paste with Command and V, transform and scale with Command and T, then desaturate with Command Shift and U. Use the Levels tool, the shortcut for which is Command and L, to darken the texture by dragging the Y output levels slider inwards. Retain enough of the brick texture so it's still subtly visible. The vibrant neon glow effect will be produced by a cocktail of layer styles. Double click the top layer and begin with an inner glow. Click reset to default so we're working from the same starting point. Change the blending mode to linear dodge, then max out the opacity to 100%. Then click center as the source and move the slider to around 7 to 10 pixels, enough to leave a portion of the original color fading in around the edge of the tube. Add an outer glow next, reset to default, then alter the settings to overlay, a size of around 100%, and an opacity of around 75% just to take the hard edge off the tubes with a soft glow instead. The main coloured glows will be produced using the drop shadow effect. Reset to default first, then change the settings to linear dodge and a colour that matches the original colour of the tubes. Max out the opacity, then bump up the size to around 24 pixels with zero distance to add a small coloured glow around the lines. Click the little plus icon next to the drop shadow effect to layer up another. This time bump the size up to around 150 pixels to extend the glow further. Layering up these two effects helps spread the ambience without losing the intensity closer to the tube. Add another drop shadow, but this time reset to default. Configure these settings to overlay with black, with a distance and size of 10 pixels to add subtle shading to the tubes. Set the opacity to around 50%. Add the same layer style effects to the other layers, but alter the colour of the two drop shadows to produce the correct ambient glows for each coloured tube. Add a new layer above the brick texture and set up a soft brush tip. Choose a colour that closely matches each of the neon tubes and dab a few spots over and around each shape. Change this layer's blending mode to soft light and reduce the opacity to around 40% to add further vibrancy to the glow effect. Zoom into the document and add another new layer. Draw a small circle over the end of one of the tubes and fill it with black. Then add a bevel and emboss layer style with maximum depth. Turn off the auto select option for the move tool to make this step easier, then hold the alt key to drag out a series of duplicates, placing each one at the end of every tube. This step is a nice finishing touch that helps improve the realism a little by grounding each neon tube into the background. It probably doesn't look quite as real on a brick wall, but it's a detail that enhances the overall effect. The final result is a bright neon sign effect with an array of coloured glows. Taking the time to construct the artwork out of lines that don't cross or intersect helps produce a believable neon effect that looks similar to the appearance of real neon sign designs. The Photoshop steps then help bring it to life by illuminating those shapes into fluorescent tubes. So if you enjoyed this tutorial or learnt anything new, be sure to give the tutorial a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel to stick around for more, and join my mailing list at Spoon Graphics if you want to get your hands on my free design resources bundle. As always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.